Hi and welcome everyone here on 2K Sports. Can't wait to get some NBA action going. This is Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and Doris Burke. Also joining us from the sidelines, David Aldridge.
This is a staple in the East Concourse.
Here we are in November. Let's see how things are shaking out in the West early in the season. You look at Tucson. They're sixth best right now, looking to make a move up in the standings. And, of course, Nashville, they're five spots away.
Looking at Nashville, they've been stuck in a rut the entire season. We talk about teams maximizing their potential. Well, the opposite's been the case with this group.
I think, Greg, for them, it's obviously been very disappointing. And I get the sense it's starting to weigh on them night in and night out.
So the Tucson starting five. Johnson is out there with ABC, then it's ABC, then it's Williams, and it's Jerome in a point. And for Nashville, they've got the general, Brown out there with Hayes, and it's ABC, and it's Alexander Walker in at the two-guard spot. Doris, teams sometimes struggle right out of the blocks. When do they generally hit, in your opinion, the panic button?
Well, let's hope the panic button doesn't get hit for anybody, Kevin. But the one thing that would concern any team, obviously, is injury to a star, either an established star or a rookie they're trying to get good minutes for. But, boy, if you're hitting the panic button this early, look out.
But the one thing is, Doris, you can really kind of rectify the situation because of the length of the regular season.
No doubt, Kevin. An NBA year affords plenty of opportunities to find your footing.
Here's Alexander Walker. Now the pass to Hayes. That shot off. Now Tucson takes it the other way.
Well, on the road, you don't expect to look so comfortable on the offensive end, but that was the story of the game.
It came down to execution. No wasted possessions, and that is absolutely essential trying to win on the road.
Here's ABC. Tucson making their last shot. They get a hand on it. Fast break. Here comes Tucson. Here's Miles. And finished off by Miles.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
At the end of the day, though, it's 2 points. Don't hang your heads. Let's get refocused and play with more patience.
For Tucson, they've gone 2 of 3 here to start out the game. Over in the corner, Williams. And there's another one for Tucson.
Such a multi-talented threat on the offensive end, and you love his confidence.
Alexander Walker passes to the general. Uses both hands to slam it down.
That's a finish he'll be bragging about for a while.
As he should. Very impressive.
How about that from your point guard, gentlemen? Playing big at the rim. Okay.
Tucson shooting their first shots of the night from the charity stripe.
And just to mention, a season ago, they were very comfortable at the line, hitting about 78% of their free throws.
First free throw is good. That one falls, so he hits both of them.
And at the line, it's all about consistency with him. His routine, his stroke, it never wavers.
Passes it to ABC. Can't hit that one. Good D by Williams. For Tucson, they've gone 3 of 4 from the field to start out the game. With the floater, and the layup is up and in. Williams has got 6.
Well, instead of forcing it all the way to the cup, he just goes with that little teardrop.
Here's the general. He has 5. Feeds it to Hayes. And Hayes throws it down.
Well, know, deliver the pass where your teammate can do something with it. Nice.
Tucson leading by three. Jerome passes to ABC. Oh, and there's the alley-oop.
And now you see them starting to really work the ball inside.
And here's Nashville. Pass to Brown. Here's the general. 1:35 left to play in the first quarter. And he makes that one.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
And I think defensively, that is not the way you want to start. Giving up high percentage looks, that doesn't typically end well.
And Tucson has possession. Nashville getting their last shot to go. And here's Hayes. He's coming off a 16-point game again.
And three blocks on the game as well. I mean, he was going all out and making plays defensively.
Now, here's Miles to the inside. Johnson misses the layup.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
That boy, to have someone back there who can erase your mistakes, what a big-time asset defensively.
Here's Jerome. Nashville getting their last shot to go. The pass to ABC. And they're pushing it up. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Williams can't get it to go.
I'll tell you, most of the time, this guy's going to finish that. But that was tremendous defense that prohibits him from completing the play.
Alexander Walker passes to the general. And here's Hayes. Shoots over Miles. Here's Alexander Walker. And no good. Had a chance to take the lead there. So at the end of one quarter of play, still a close game. Tucson leads by one. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break. We hope you're enjoying the game. Both teams tonight keeping things pretty even so far on the scoreboard. And taking a look at Tucson's performance here, guys. What have they been doing or not doing?
Well, the offense is clicking, and they seem to have seized the momentum here early on.
Boy, it's been a really pretty thing to watch, executing their game plan to perfection.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade as the second quarter gets going. On the court for Tucson, we've got Johnson.
Kramer.
ABC is out there with King. And it's ABC.
Good job attacking. Those restricted area shots are what every NBA team is looking for.
Pass to Hayes. Nashville passing it around. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. Of course, you've seen a lot of these big men come and go in this league. Who would you say right now is the most complete big man in the NBA?
Well, two guys come to my mind immediately, and that's Joel Embiid, who I think probably could be more efficient with his three-point shooting, but is still enough of a threat that you have to guard him out there. They enter the ball through him in the post, and he can be a dominant scorer. He can also put it on the deck. And then Anthony Davis, who you could say all of those attributes that Joel Embiid has, the brow has as well. Those are two of the most complete, dominant two-way big men in today's game.
And he knocks down the first one. Both good from the line that time. Tucson with the ball. That game will be a quick pit stop before hitting the road again. King outside. Passes it to ABC. Drills it from outside. ABC's got 5 points in the quarter.
I'll tell you, you are playing with fire anytime you leave this guy open, and they just got burned.
And the foul called on ABC. That's his first foul. Bertinus, he's checked in for ABC.
Substitution for Nashville. Darius Bertinus.
Second quarter, and we're just over a minute in. Now Bertans. Five on the clock. Tries to hit him. Johnson with the block. Here's ABC. Pass to Johnson. Here's ABC. Covered by Hayes. Here's ABC. Trying to get open is Johnson. Can't cash in on the 10-foot jumper.
Not pretty. You just got to shake off a miss like that.
And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. This break in the game gives us a chance to look at the teams with the most points off turnovers last season.
And this team, in terms of scoring off of turnovers, that became the identity. I mean, they really look to disrupt and cause problems defensively.
Take a break.
And boy, do they take advantage on the other end.
He's off on the first. Harper, he's checked in for Tucson. And he's good on the second.
In this quarter, they've had the right approach, driving and drawing, initiating contact, create opportunities, get to the line.
Here is Harper. 2 minutes now played in the second quarter. Here's Johnson, falls back and drains the fadeaway jumper. Johnson's got his second bucket tonight.
He is too good a mid-range shooter to leave him that open.
Bertans with the ball. He's in the post. Johnson on him. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
Nashville shooting their fifth and sixth free throws of the game.
And going back a season ago, they were a pretty average team at the line, about 76% altogether.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first free throw is good. He makes one of two that time.
Of course, you and I were just talking about this as more and more players are going public with their trade requests. Do you think that's had a negative impact on the game?
Well, Kevin, I certainly think it makes long-term planning for NBA franchises a lot more difficult because contractually we are not seeing them hold true to the particular organization they may have signed that contract with. The reality is this in today's NBA. You've got to be nimble as an organization, and you have got to be attractive to them. And I mean that with great ownership, great leadership, and who are the players currently in your system. You have got to be incredibly nimble to be successful in today's NBA.
I think you're right on. The general, he's checked in for Nashville.
He doesn't get the second one. Nashville trails by five. Williams passes to the general. Nashville passing it around. There's the pass to Dawkins. Passes to the general. The three. And it's Tucson with the rebound. Out of bounds, Nashville takes possession. ABC's checked in for Dawkins. And here's Nashville, trailing by five. 1:58 left to play here in the second quarter. Nailed from three-point land.
Pick works well there. Not much resistance from the D.
It takes incredible effort to stay connected to the hip of the offensive player. You've got to want to work. Well, you got to think better of that next time. He had little to no chance of conversion.
Williams with the steal. Fires for three. It's rebounded by Hayes. For Nashville, they've gone 1 of 3 to start out the second quarter. Here's the general. He's guarded by Harper. Here's the general. Williams kicks to Hayes. Good. Great play by Williams to set it up. Hayes has got it all tied up now for Nashville.
Well, that's not the guy you want guarding him at the rim. Just too much of a differential in terms of size.
On the wing, Williams. He picked up 15 points in their last win again.
Now, I'll bet even they didn't think the pick would work that well.
No, no, no. And they get the major league dunk out of it, too.
And my question is, where was the help? Someone rotate over and challenge.
And you could see him give a little nod and then just burst to the rim for the alley-oop slam.
A pair of teammates, Greg, with a terrific feel for each other. Now here's Williams. He's got 8. Sinks the three-pointer.
Well, the advantage they have right now is largely based on his play. What an outstanding night.
Here's the general. Let's a floater go. Whistle blows. Basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play.
How about that one? Able to maintain control and finish the play.
For Nashville, they have shot 67% from the line tonight, going 4-6.
He does a great job of drawing contact and getting himself to the line, something he didn't do in the first period.
For Tucson, they've gone 5 of 8 from the floor here in the second quarter, over 60% shooting. Floats it up for Williams, taken away by Hayes. Here's ABC. It's good.
ABC!
And Nashville leads by 2.
Now, Kev, this is what you're looking for on offense. Take advantage of the big man you have. Get him an easy look at the rim.
Back right after this.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, folks, can't tell you how much it means to us to have you back with us on the Halftime Show on 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal. Means the world, doesn't it?
Yes, yeah.
And guys, for Nashville, Kenny, what's your take?
Well, I think they're feeling the energy of this hometown crowd. Sometimes you get a little complacent and comfortable in your surroundings, but no, they fed off adrenaline in the first half.
And Shaq, let's get your input on the visiting team.
I think they let the game come to them, but they haven't got to the foul line enough, Ernie. That's an area where they're getting beat. I like to see them press to action a little bit more.
And that's a wrap. With the third quarter approaching, we now send you back to Kevin and the crew.
It's a moment when I saw God, I'm saying why. And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been fairly even so far. Ah!
And Tucson shooting 59% up to this point. They're working for great shots, and they're hitting them. They've got ABC. Hayes out there with Brown. And there's the general. And it's Alexander Walker in at the two spot.
Oh, how about the finesse there? Nice little gentle touch on the board.
And you know, when you have that gentle touch, those tip-ins are easy to come by. And for Tucson, Williams is out there with Johnson. And it's ABC, and it's ABC, and it's Jerome in at the one spot. Yes. And they pick up two. Hayes has got 14 points.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
And for Nashville, we've got Brown. He's out there with ABC. Hayes out there with the general. And it's Alexander Walker in at the shooting guard position. Here's Johnson, and that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
That's his first personal foul.
Doris, you've accomplished so much in your award-winning career. What was your first experience in broadcasting?
Kevin, my first experience was I left coaching, and they put Providence College women's basketball on radio. That was the first ever game I got to call. It was so cool. Tell me yours. What was the very first? Did you study this? How did you get into broadcasting?
I did. Our high school had a radio station, and the first basketball broadcast was underneath the bleachers, looking through popcorn boxes and legs of the people that were standing in the bleachers so that I could see the court from the baseline.
Amazing.
Because that's where the telephone cables were to plug in our equipment. And
wow.
I was 16 years old.
Incredible.
Remembered very well.
Incredible.
Very well. He hits both from the stripe. And so it's Nashville with it. Throws it up high. Great communication on the alley-oop.
Oh, and just a soft touch on both ends of that pretty alley-oop.
I got to say, when he threw the pass, I didn't know where it was going. Here's Jerome. Outside Williams. They shoot again. Pass to Miles. And once again off the mark by Tucson.
1 for 5 has got to be a frustrating start, and they just don't look sharp right now. Can they find their offensive game?
Now here's Hayes. He's got 16, and it goes down 2 points.
And obviously his momentum from the last game has carried over here tonight.
Now, I think that's the one thing every player is searching for, consistency. They're giving this guy a chance to carry the offense once again.
And you got to love the big bucket in the paint in this sort of a grind-it-out game.
Here's ABC. Clock at 6. Pass to Alexander Walker. 3-pointer. And again, it's Nashville from deep.
80% shooting to start the third. 4 for 5.
Tucson trails by 5. A touch over 2.5 minutes of basketball played here in the third quarter. For Nashville, they've gotten 4 of their first 5 second-half shots to fall. 80% since the break. Here's ABC. Here's the general. Vicious to Hayes. And taken away by Johnson. 1:52 left in the third quarter of the game. That's tipped. Oh, and a fast break for Nashville.
Ooh.
Oh!
Wow.
And the powerful one-handed slam.
This sort of awesome dunk is one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game.
Well, there's a swagger out there. You can see it on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either. And Tucson calls their first timeout of the game. And Nashville making a change here. Hawkins checked in. Let's take this chance to see which of last season's teams had the most second chance points in the league.
That's an effort stat for me. I mean, it shows you how hard this team works in the paint. They continue to pound the backboard.
And the pass to ABC.
4 on the shot clock. LaQue off target from outside. Nashville leading by 5. We've got 108 left in the third. Passes it to the general. Out in his own on the break. LaQue lays it in off the breakaway.
And that's such good work to make this a one-possession game. Terrific steal to get it all started.
Alexander Walker passes to Hayes. And a bit of a battle here for the ball. The official signals a jump ball here. And Tucson has possession. Tucson trails by 3. Pass to ABC. Six on the shot clock. Now the pass to ABC. And the rebound goes to Nashville. Here's Dawkins. Pass to the general. And it's King with the rebound.
And he did everything he could to make that shot as difficult as possible.
We call that a great contest. You know, this is something he brings to the table, the ability to anchor your defense.
We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. Nashville out in front. They lead by 3. And time for the short break, and stay right where you are. The fourth quarter is coming up next. Reach the fourth quarter, and what has been a very competitive game should be an exciting finish. Nashville leading by 3. On the court for Tucson, they've got ABC. King is out there with Williams. Then it's Johnson, and it's Jerome in a point guard. Here's Alexander Walker. Shot clock at 6. Now, here's Bertans, defended by Miles.
Jackson.
He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
And those second chance points really become almost like bonus points when you can get them.
Here's Williams.
Oh! That was worth the price of admission.
Hayes.
And talk about putting some extra on it. That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, he's going to finish firm when he gets the space. The general is checked in for Nashville.
What's up?
That's good from Williams. Just a tiny lead for him.
And a chance to make it a little bigger right here.
Here's the general. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
Just the kind of play they need in a game this close.
You know, that's the kind of aggression they want from their floor leader.
Boy, and not just the aggression, Kev. The ability to get to the rim, but how about the finish with intention?
And that's right in his wheelhouse, looking to make an impact when it counts.
This is a player who understands when the game is hanging in the balance, he knows it's winning time.
Here's Alexander Walker. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Nashville needs to get off a shot. Here's Dawkins. The shot's good. Brown making the play.
Dawkins!
And Nashville leads by 4.
You know what? Sometimes something good can come out of a bad possession.
Here's Jerome, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
Timeout.
Vital basket there. This is just the time and really just the situation when he looks to take over.
Timeout called, Nashville.
All right, fans, get on your feet and make some noise for T-shirt time!
We'll be right back. ABC's checked in for Dawkins. ABC's checked in for Tucson. He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Hey, guys, during the break, I heard Nashville's coach talking with his team. He told them, hey, this game is there for you, but we got to go get it. 50-50 balls, getting to the basket. We have to give it all right now. Kevin?
And so it's Nashville with it. The lead is two. Yes. And Hayes throws it down.
And you can see him give a little nod and then just burst to the rim for the alley-oop slam.
A pair of teammates, Greg, with a terrific feel for each other. Jerome passes to Johnson over Hayes. And there's another one for Tucson.
In the mid-range, rarely the hallmark of efficiency in today's NBA, but it is on point tonight.
Now here's Hayes, and they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Hayes, no good on the free throw. Tucson trails by four. Pass to Miles. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
Two shots.
That's his second personal foul. Shooting for Tucson. Miles. Taking two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Free throw good, Miles.
This is as good as it gets from the charity stripe here in the second.
And that's good as he hits both of his shots. We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. Here's the general. They get it back. Hayes banked in off the glass. Hayes has got 14 points now in the second half.
And really an alert play on the glass there to get that second chance opportunity. He's having one of those games that we've really grown accustomed to seeing him put forth.
Yeah, he's back-to-back games like this. He is on a tear, competing with every ounce of energy he's got.
And with his game closing in on the final buzzer, let's take a look at our Jordan player of the game.
And guys, no doubt who our pick was going to be. He's made everyone else on the court look like they're playing at half speed. It's been total domination, and you can't help but just sit back and admire that performance.
Tucson trails by four. Here's Jerome on the wing. Johnson shot from 16.
Come on.
And once again off the mark by Tucson. Pass to ABC. No good with the triple. For Tucson, they've gone an outstanding 4-5 from the field in the fourth quarter so far. Inside. Good for his eighth field goal. He's attempted a dozen shots.
And that's about the worst defense I can imagine a team playing coming down the stretch.
You know, we talk about execution offensively coming down the stretch. To me, it's as important defensively, and they didn't have it.
And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
That's his third personal foul. At the line for Nashville. Hayes. Two shots.
He hits the first one, and that makes it a three-point lead. Hey.
And so both free throws are good. And it's a four-point ball game.
Well, this is why you run your offense through him in important situations. You know he's going to deliver.
On the wing, Johnson. Over Brown. And that one is off. Now Nashville takes it the other way. The pass to Hayes. Here's the general. Passes to ABC. The tray. And it's Tucson with the rebound.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the three. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
Pass to Hayes. Shoots from the elbow. ABC, the second chance points on the tip in. ABC's got the lead up to six now for Nashville.
How about the anticipation and the timing there? He is all over it.
Pass to Johnson. Baseline J on the way. Almost, but it rolls out. And so they foul intentionally.
Shooting for Nashville.
In general.
Taking two shots.
Good on the first, and that makes it a 7-point lead. So it gets them both, and it's an 8-point game.
Disappointing day for them. Let's see if they go down with the fight.
Well, they definitely have some things to work out, and you'd love to see them finish this game the right way.
They could stretch the lead to double digits.
I mean, which would obviously put them in a very comfortable position.
Here's Alexander Walker. So Nashville wins it. Some good competition, but the hometown advantage and their ability to stay focused, I think, made the difference.
Yeah, and the first step in becoming a good team is your ability to win at home. And they really seem to revel in that opportunity. And this is what they came out to do.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. So long, everyone.